Good morning, St. John the Evangelist Moffat and All Saints Lockerbie welcome you to the online Remembrance Sunday. Let us begin the service by singing the hymn, O God, our help in ages past. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Let's pray. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. God is love, and we are God's children. There is no room for fear in love. We love because God loved us first. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith. God our Father, we confess to you and to our fellow members in the body of Christ that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have failed to do. We are truly sorry. Forgive us our sins, and deliver us from the power of evil. For the sake of your Son, who died for us, Jesus Christ, our Lord. God, who is both power and love, forgive us and free us from our sins. Heal and strengthen us by God's Spirit, and raise us to new life in Christ our Lord. Amen. O God, it is your will to hold both heaven and earth in a single peace. Let the design of your great love shine on the waste of our wrath and sorrows, and give peace to your church, peace among nations, peace in our homes and peace in our hearts. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Now let us listen to the word of God.
The first reading is taken from the book of Daniel, chapter 12, verses 1 to 3. In the third year of King Cyrus, a word was revealed to Daniel. At that time, Michael, the great prince, the protector of your people, shall arise. There shall be a time of anguish such as never has occurred since nations first came into existence. But at the time, your people shall be delivered, everyone who is found written in the book. Many of those who sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake, some to everlasting life, and some to shame and everlasting contempt. Those who are wise shall rise, those who are wise shall shine like the brightness of the sky, and those who lead many to righteousness, like the stars forever and ever. This is the word of the Lord.
Today's psalm is Psalm 16. Preserve me, O God, for in you have I taken refuge. I have said to the Lord, you are my Lord. All my good depends on you. All my delight is upon the godly that are in the land, upon those who are noble in heart. Though the idols are legion, that they may run after, they drink offerings of blood, I will not offer, neither make mention of their names upon my lips. The Lord himself is my portion and my cup. In your hands alone is my fortune. My share has fallen in a fair land. Indeed, I have a goodly heritage. I will bless the Lord who has given me counsel, and in the night watches he instructs my heart. I have set the Lord always before me. He is at my right hand. I shall not fall. Wherefore my heart is glad and my spirit rejoices. My flesh also shall rest secure. For you will not abandon my soul to death, nor suffer your faithful one to see the pit. You will show me the path of life. In your presence is the fullness of joy, and in your right hand are pleasures forevermore. Thanks be to God. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark. Glory to Christ our Saviour. As Jesus came out of the temple, one of his disciples said to him, "Look, teacher, what large stones and what large buildings." Then Jesus asked him, "Do you see these great buildings? Not one stone will be left here upon another. All will be thrown down." When he was sitting on the Mount of Olives, opposite the temple, Peter, James, John, and Andrew asked him privately, "Tell us, when will this be? And what will be the sign that all these things are about to be accomplished?" Then Jesus began to say to them, "Beware that no one leads you astray. Many will come in my name and say, 'I am he,' and they will lead many astray. When you hear of wars and rumors of wars, do not be alarmed. This must take place, but the end is still to come. For nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. There will be earthquakes in various places. There will be famines. This is but the beginning of the birth pangs." Give thanks to the Lord for his glorious gospel. Praise to Christ our Lord.
Let us pray. Lord, guide us through your word for us today to learn from the sacrifice of others on how we may serve you to ensure that war shall be no more and to seek harmonious relations with all our neighbours. Amen. My text this morning comes from verses 7 and 8 of our Gospel reading. When you hear of wars and rumours of wars, do not be alarmed. This must take place, but the end is still to come, for nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. I was born in 1952, and throughout my life, there have been wars going on somewhere in the world. None, though, that match the ferocity of the First and Second World Wars. In the first, or better known as the War to End All Wars, 9 million men and women gave their lives, and 21 million service people were injured, many with life-changing injuries. Just 21 years later came the Second World War. If our text is literally correct, why do we bother to remember the sacrifice of so many human beings? It is easy, when you are young and naive, to revel in the glory of war. As one matures, one sees, especially with our modern technological advances and almost instant distribution of news, the true horrors of war for both combatants and non-combatants. Christ died to save us, but that didn't mean an end to violence. Because we can follow the lives of the key disciples and see with hindsight how few of them died a peaceful death and instead gave their lives in the interests of peace and love, as do many contemporary Christian missionaries. One of my favourite war poets is Wilfred Owen, who sets out the true horror of war when he describes the result of a chlorine gas attack in a poem called Dulce et Decorum, Est Pro Patria Mori, a title borrowed from the Roman poet Horace. The English translation is, "It is sweet and right to die for one's country." As a Christian, although war is abhorrent to me, I accept there are times when, as the Gospel writer says, war must take place. If we had not defeated the potential thousand-year Third Reich in 1945, I would not have the freedom to preach today, nor would you have the freedom to choose to come here to worship. Instead, you would have been worshipping some strange pagan religion that Hitler and his henchmen had created. So today is about honouring the men and women who over many centuries have fought and given their lives in pursuit of freedom. It is about more than remembering sacrifice, because it is about building on that sacrifice by remembering how important dialogue and reconciliation attempts are between conflicting nations. Our Gospel passage reminds us that making the ultimate sacrifice for us, Christ did not promise the result would be an easy ride for us. Remembrance of all those combatants who have given their lives for freedom is equally important, because when we forget that it is easy to think war can be a quick fix, we struggle to remember that when you look at the situation, for example, in Afghanistan, where so many great nations like ourselves, Russia, and the United States have tried to resolve by war and failed miserably. Christ is not physically present here today, but God gave us the Holy Spirit to guide us in right ways. And however dismal sometimes things seem, the world is a much better place than it was in 1945, because we have a sort of peace. Uneasy though it may be, we can all serve to work to maintain it by ensuring the sacrifices we make are not in war, but to help those for whom war seems an obvious solution, to see that in fact there are many other ways of moving forward to achieve a fulfilled kingdom of God on earth. Our armed forces are an essential element of maintaining peace. It is also a vital reminder to us that the symbol of today, the humble poppy, brings hope because it appears naturally in its greatest numbers where there has been turmoil, but now there is peace. Wars do not, in the view of the Gospel writer, mean signs of the end times. Sadly, they are just part of the world we live in and a reminder to us to strive for peace and listen to God. Amen.
We are here to worship Almighty God, whose purposes are good, whose power sustains the world he has made, who loves us, though we have failed in his service, who gave Jesus Christ for the life of the world, and who by his Holy Spirit leads us in his way. As we give thanks for his great works, we remember those who have lived and died in his service and in the service of others. We pray for all who suffer through war and are in need. We ask for his help and blessing that we may do his will and that the whole world may acknowledge him as Lord and King.
They shall grow not old as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
John Christie Aitken, William Ogle Bellerving, Frederick Bewley, James Clark, Duncan Cooper, Ronald James Jardine, John Roberts, James Studholme, Frederick Wardhaw, James Edward Wardhaw. They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn.
At the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
Thank you.
When you go home, tell them of us and say, for your tomorrow, we gave our today.
Almighty and eternal God, from whose love in Christ we cannot be parted, either by death or life, hear our prayers and thanksgivings for all whom we remember this day. Fulfill in them the purpose of your love, and bring us all with them to your eternal joy. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Let us commit ourselves to responsible living and faithful service. Will you strive for all that makes for peace?
We will.
We will.
Will you seek to heal the wounds of war?
We will.
Will you work for a just future for all humanity?
We will.
Merciful God, we offer to you the fears in us that have not yet been cast out by love. May we accept the hope you have placed in the hearts of all people and live lives of justice, courage and mercy. Through Jesus Christ, our risen Redeemer. Amen. Amen.
And now let us pray. I begin our prayers with a special prayer for today, written by the Reverend Dr. Douglas Galbraith of Markinch, centered around our gospel reading. Time after time, God of the ages, when stones have been cast down, a people driven out, fields destroyed, have you not come to the rescue, breaking the bows of the mighty, causing the feeble to find strength, raising the poor from the dust? We call upon you today, Lord, when so many people have been driven from their homes and for whom the end of the world seems to have come. In their millions, they surge across the globe, storm borders, take to the seas, overflow the encampments, seek new life in strange lands. Yet you, O Lord, from the time of incarnation, are now so much a part of this, suffering too, struggling too, but showing where hope lies. Offering life in the midst of death and despair, as close to this world as a potter to the clay, endlessly making and remaking. So we offer our prayers as materials for the reworking of your peace amongst us, for the shaping of hope, for outlining new life. We bring before you those who share in this reworking, those who refuse to let evil alone, who, like the prophets, challenge and cause discomfort, who act and pray and remain expectant and refuse to be disappointed. And now some specific prayers relating to our congregations. We remember members of our congregations who have died in conflict, fighting for our freedom, and relatives or friends of members who have similarly died. We give thanks for their sacrifice for our future. We remember members, relatives and friends who have suffered life-changing injuries in the service of their country and pray for your continuing love and care for them. We give thanks for the work of COP26 and pray that the results will be honoured and the work it agrees be carried out to enable a recovery of your creation, O Lord. We pray for our Primus Mark and our Bishop Kevin and Father Paul and all his fellow priests, as well as our worship leaders and vestries, as they seek to bring your message of peace and love in Lockerbie and Moffat and throughout the diocese. We remember before you, O Lord, all those in our congregations and others known to us who are unwell at this time, thinking especially of Mary Marr, Hildred Uni, and Julia Carruthers. And we pray today for the family and friends of Robert Russell, as they come to terms with his loss, and we give thanks for his service to the Church in so many ways. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Let us present our offerings to the Lord. Yours, Lord, is the greatness, the power, the glory, the splendor, and the majesty. For everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own we give you. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise. Worship and praise belong to you, Father, in every place and at all times. All power is yours. You created the heavens and established the earth. You sustain in being all that is. In Christ, your Son, our life and yours are brought together in a wonderful exchange. He made his home among us that we might forever dwell in you. Through your Holy Spirit, you call us to new birth in a creation restored by love. As children of your redeeming purpose, we offer you our praise. With angels and archangels and the whole company of heaven, singing the hymn of your unending glory. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Glory and thanksgiving be to you, most loving Father, for the gift of your Son born in human flesh. He is the Word existing beyond time, both source and final purpose, bringing to wholeness all that is made. Obedient to your will, he died upon the cross. By your power, you raised him from the dead. He broke the bonds of evil and set your people free to be his body in the world. On the night when he was given up to death, knowing that his hour had come, having loved his own, he loved them to the end. At supper with his disciples, he took bread and offered you thanks. He broke the bread and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, it is broken for you." After supper, he took the cup. He offered you thanks and gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant. It is poured out for you and for all, that sins may be forgiven. Do this in remembrance of me." We now obey your Son's command. We recall his blessed passion and death, his glorious resurrection and ascension, and we look for the coming of his kingdom, made one with him. We offer you these gifts, and with them ourselves, a single, holy, living sacrifice. Hear us, most merciful Father, and send your Holy Spirit upon us, and upon this bread and this wine, that overshadowed by his life-giving power, they may be the body and blood of your Son, and we may be kindled with the fire of your love, and renewed for the service of your kingdom. Help us, who are baptized into the fellowship of Christ's body, to live and work to your praise and glory. May we grow together in unity and love, until at last, in your new creation, we enter into our heritage, in the company of the Virgin Mary, the apostles and prophets, and of all our brothers and sisters, living and departed. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory be to you, Lord of all ages, world without end. Amen. The living bread is broken for the life of the world. Lord, unite us in this sign. As our Savior has taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Do not bring us to the time of trial, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Give thanks to our gracious God, whose mercy endures forever. Let's pray. Eternal God, comfort of the afflicted and healer of the broken, you have fed us at the table of life and hope. Teach us the ways of gentleness and peace. that all the world may acknowledge the kingdom of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us receive God's blessing. The God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus, that great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the eternal covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.